Hello YouTube, this is Frank from Architecture Aesthetics, and today in this video, I'm going to share with you guys the first project for my last undergrad studio course, and the objective is to represent Sou Fujimoto's Musashino library through a composite drawing and a conceptual model. So before delving into our treatment to the project, just a very brief introduction to the Musashino library. Constructed in 2010 and commissioned by the Musashino University of Art, the Musashino Library slash Art Gallery is an ambitious project through which the architect Sou Fujimoto attempts to reimagine the form of a library as a giant, continuous, spiraling bookshelf, which insinuates the infiniteness and constant growth of human knowledge. Moreover, the architect also managed to synthesize a pair of polarizing ideas, which he termed as searchability, which refers to the rationally premeditated positions of the book stacks, which allow the readers to find their subject of interest through a numeric dial-like navigation system, and strollability, which refers to the spontaneous, self-initiated routes induced by the maze-like interior space. So to represent this project through a composite drawing, which means the combination of multiple architectural representation techniques seamlessly in one composition, my partner Brian and I decided to distill this project down to its core essence, which is of course the spiraling bookshelf. As you can see that our final composition comprises of several modules, each with a different representation technique, but all of which engage the coiling bookshelf. So the most prominent element is of course the bookshelf being uncoiled and pulled up from one end. This element is done in a perspective view and is made literally by uncoiling the wall of the library. And in the middle of the composition is an oblique view of the Musashino library. And at the bottom of our composition, we have a juxtaposition of the plan, the oblique drawing, and the warped plan to further insinuate the spiraling form. Moreover, we used very thin lines to represent the major programs of the library, including the grand staircase, the student study corral, and the second story catwalk, which are all projected from the center of the plan drawings, passing through their respective positions in the library. This is to give our audience a general sense of idea of where these programs are situated, hence engaging Fujimoto-san's original concept of searchability. As for our physical model, our ambition is to add more dynamics to the height of the spiraling bookshelf, to really accentuate the path indicated in Fujimoto's original diagram. The path connects the major entrance and exit points and serves as the most prominent route of going about the library. So stemming from this parti, our treatment to the wall height is fairly simple. So the further away the wall is from the central path, the taller it becomes, whereas the closer it is to the path, the shorter it shrinks. In order to achieve this, we deploy the grasshopper definition to help us visualize this idea. As you can see in this diagram, first of all, we generated a grid of columns whose height information is defined by the distance from their base point to their closest point on the path, and then we use these columns to generate a surface, which is later used to split the model of the Musashino library to get what we have been looking for, which is a structure that has the same plan information as the Musashino library, but this time around with a much more intricate yet logical set of elevations. And in our physical model, hopefully you can see that the path can be very intuitively detected by mentally tracing the short walls and keeping away from the tall ones. And this is our way of enforcing a sense of ease of navigation onto this maze-like structure, while also at the same time engage Fujimoto's concept of strollability. Alright guys, so that wraps up our analysis project of Sou Fujimoto's Musashino Library. I hope you guys found this video informative, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. And I'll see all of you in the next video. Bye bye.